No, I make the best of it, eh? Hi everyone, it's Punk here, coming to you live on Twitch. You can check me out at popularanimepunk.twitch.tv.com. You can hit the follow button if you want to follow along on the channel. What you see right now is a different layout. Apparently, I restarted my laptop and Streamlabs forgot my fucking setup again. So I'm back in the saddle again, trying to recreate my setup properly so it's functional and it works and it's entertaining and it's punk, you know. So there's a lot of black screen. It's not normal like the last stream I had where it actually looked pretty decent. This isn't the first time this has happened. This has been going on for 2 weeks now. 2 weeks straight that I've been having to redo my fucking stream. Re-editing the scenes, re-editing the sources. There was an update. And my laptop was like, oh, I didn't know. So I apologize if this setup isn't entertaining or isn't eye-popping or captivating. But nevertheless, the audio is working. We're streaming. We've been on for 8 minutes. So thank you for watching. Thank you for checking out the channel. We got a great show in store today. Minus the fact that, you know, I'm having issues with Streamlabs and buffering issues and frame rate drops and all the other shit that comes with live streaming on Twitch. So, you gotta love it. Sometimes you just need a Snickers and just like, fuck. You feel better? No, I feel worse. I'm not, I don't mind Snickers. I'm more of a Milky Way type of fan. But that's just me. So anyway, I'm a fan of a follower on Twitch. And I'm part of the community, and part of the Discord, and one of the members is not feeling so well. And I feel bad, and I wanted to reach out with this stream, and hope that they watch, or they hear about it. So I'm going to share a song that I wrote for this certain person, and in hopes that it gets to them. If not, they could check it out on the YouTube channel playlist, on the Discord, which I'll do that. But to the community of Wonderland, I hope everything goes well. I like hanging out, on the channel. I like following along with that channel. I like supporting the channel. I like the community. They accept me, and they care about me as a punk. Yeah, they call me punk. Which is cool. Unlike other communities where they don't give a fuck about me. And I'm just like a nobody. I actually have another community that actually, you know, fucking stands up and says, hey, you know, Punk is actually really good. Punk actually has a decent fucking channel, you know. He has decent fucking quality content to watch and entertain others. In his own sense of style. That's true. I do. Even though I'm not a gamer per se, I'm more of just a talker. But you know, I do a lot. I try to do a lot for staying on Twitch, and I try to do a lot to stay on YouTube and social media. So I try to do a lot. I overwork myself to the bare bone. And sometimes it's stressful. You know, sometimes it's annoying as fuck. Sometimes it is tricky and difficult at times. But it's not easy. It's definitely not easy. For me, the most difficult part is getting past the 30-minute mark. So, if I can get past the 30-minute mark, we nailed it. So, nevertheless, I really do appreciate the viewership. I really do appreciate the follows. And I do appreciate, you know, the feedback on the Discord and on Twitch DMs and all that. I do appreciate, you know, the support on that. Do I get it enough of that? No, I don't. Would I like more? Yes. Would it be helpful? Very much so. But I can stress out all I want. I can complain all I want. I can tell you how it is, but in the long run, do you really fucking care? No, you don't. And that's the fucking truth. That's the cold damn truth. Served it up on a silver platter. And like I said, it's not like people are vindictive. It's not like people are, you know, not interested in watching the channel, because, you know, when I stream on a different time zone, so it's all about timing, and I try to make the best time of what I have in the day, and in my time zone. So if I'm online and people can't watch, a lot of people watch my channel offline, and that's where a lot of viewership comes from. Should be vice versa, but nevertheless, I digress. So I really don't. I really have to say one thing about this. This setup, it is decent. It's called Midnight Red setup. It's a decent setup. I mean, it has a starting soon. It has a be right back. It has ending soon. It has an intermission. I don't know what the fucking intermission is, but I guess intermission was like maybe like a commercial break, which I guess I could do something with the commercial break intermission. Which would be pretty cool, but this isn't really like the setup I want. My setup I have is Proper Anime Punk's setup, and you know, adding all the widgets and all the other fucking shit, you know, make it all look all fancy and nice and pretty. You know, sometimes it the buffering or the frame rate drops, which it happens, but you know, to restart every single fucking day of the week, when I'm doing this daily live streams, you know, Monday through Saturday, you know, for an hour, 2 hours, 3 hours max, it does hinder my creativity, and it does hinder my happiness, which, to be honest, I don't need anything hindering my happiness. I really don't. I'm not in the mood, and I'm not in the greatest of moments of dealing with depression and sadness and feelings of God damn it. It's happening again, you know? The fucking issues, the fucking technical difficulties of putting on a great show. I don't want to go down that path again. So, to counteract that and to counterbalance that, this is what I got so far. So, if it sounds good on audio wise, if it sounds good to the listener, if it looks somewhat pleasing to the viewer, thank you. I'm doing the best. I'm doing the best. I have I'm gonna test out a song, see if it works. It's called Wanna Get Out of Oz. It's an 8-minute song. I'm gonna test it out for 8 minutes. Make sure the audio sounds good. And check the somewhat better. See, this is my layout. It takes me a while to get it all set up again. But I like to just jump right in, and it works. But I had to redo everything, so it's like, oh. Giant. Popular anime punk. Hopefully, the audio sounds good. This is a new song called Tell Me Why. This setup, don't get me wrong, I like it. I just wish it always stays. Don't know if it's too loud for the listener or the viewer, but if it is, let me know. You can DM me on Twitch with Whisper, you can hit me up on the Discord. You can comment down. You can comment, message me on Facebook. Comment on my YouTube channel, which I'll read my comments. Anyway, to reach out to me. Help me help you. Keep everything going smooth and keeping the wheels spinning. Keeping the fuel pumping. I sort of like this slideshow. This looks cool. Alright, this is good. Alright. Okay. Okay, so. Today, I woke up and I had a friend that is going through some issues. Nothing too bad. Nothing too concerning, but needs a little help. Will pick me up. Recovering. And I wanted to reach out through the community of the community on the Wonderland community here on Twitch. And I'm a part of, and I wanted to help out another fellow streamer, popular anime punks. We help out other streamers when we can. Well, we try. But to Anime Mad Hatter's Twitch channel, community, and Discord, and fandom, and friends, and Punk is a proud supporter of that channel and helps to just keep tabs and say hi and, you know, share the follows, you know, like if you like my channel, you should check out Anime Mad Hatter's channel. She does a lot of cool live streaming of VR worlds and rates them and hangs out with friends, and it's a great time to just chat and hang out. Unfortunately, I'm not like that type of channel, but it's a really cool channel to just chill out for a few minutes. So if you ever get a moment of time listening to this, please, I highly recommend you follow and support Anime Mad Hatter's Twitch channel. Tell her Punk said hi. You know, Punk's always looking out. Anyway, so because of that, you know, anime is having, or Anime Mad Hatter's having some little hiccups of her own on her channel, and I wanted to reach out, and I wrote a song regarding you know, the community in which I'm following and helping out, was just chatting. So I want to share this song that I wrote, and I hope by sharing this on my stream, she can hear it, the community can hear it. I know it's not a lot, but it's the least I can do. I do like playing guitar, I do like writing songs for people, and personal songs as well, but I like to be creative, and when people are going through issues and having bad days, it really does affect me as a person, as an individual, because I know what it's like to have some bad days, and I know what it's like to have some rough days and have some rough seas. So to ease the seas and to ease the nerves and the and calm the waves down, I wrote this new song that's dedicated to Anime Mad Hatter's channel, called Recover. I didn't really title it, but I just want to title it Recover. So I'm gonna share it for the first time here on the channel. So here you go.
I know this probably might sound off tune or off melody, but
I'm gonna be right back. So everyone have a listen to a song that I wrote. Get well soon, my friend. Recover.
Thank you.
relax. Take some time. Take the time. Take the time. All you need, all you need, all you need is time. We're waiting. We're hanging. We're waiting for the sunshine. Your broken wings will mend over time, and you will fly again. Your broken wings will mend over time, and you will fly again. I believe in you. Even though this song is my only way of reaching you, I believe in you can get well. Just like everyone that's waiting there for you. Everyone is so concerned. We don't need to worry, 'cause you will return. Get better, get well. I hope this song makes sense to your little heart. Get well, get well. Hope you feel better. Get well. Get well, little Anna, get well. Get well, little Anna, get well. I don't want you to cry, nor shed tears, 'cause it's not your fault. I hope they do get well, my friend. We are missing you today. Return to another sunny day. Get well, Lil. Get well. Thanks for listening. We all miss you. One land. Get well. Awkward, but I guess I'm kind of trying to say it nicely, but I hope the lyrics weren't too bad. So I wanted to share a little song of inspiration to help you fight recovering. Everyone's worrying about worrying about you. Wishing you the best. So get well soon. Punk to everyone in the Wonderland community. Take care.
So like I said, there's my song. I feel great to share it here on Twitch and air it on the live stream. I try to reach out. I'll try to reach out through the YouTube. I'll try to reach out through the Discord. I'll try to reach out through the messaging on clip or whatever. But I hope one way or shape or form that song reaches the community in Wonderland. Here on Twitch, because they have the community and the friendships that I have with those people. They really have helped me out a lot, and so for me to help out on my own and get back, it's the least I could do. So, I know a lot. I know it's hard for me to just live stream and just be like, oh yeah, you know, people follow, you know, people watch, but you know, a lot of streamers, a lot of the communities are built around family and friends, and not just strangers, and we live in a small world. Very small world, even though it's a big world, we live in a very small world, but there's a small community, a small fraction of people that, you know, look out for one another, and that's what friends do. And I'm just writing a song as a friend, so I hope it doesn't come off any way, shape or form in being seen as a bad thing. I hope it's seen as a good thing. And my music, you know, artistic as it is, and then creative as it is, it's a gateway. It's an outlet for me to help my own self, but to help share thoughts and concerns of what may be, not so selfish at times. Because I worry and I care a lot about a lot of people, and I care a lot about the followers, and I care a lot about the subscribers and the viewers, and whoever you are, I really do, deep down. So if you are having, a rough day, or have any free time to chat or say hi, I appreciate it. I understand the gravity and the aspect of not being able to, hang out, not being able to jump on live stream and watch Twitch, or jump on YouTube and watch a YouTube video, or jump on and see a little short clip. I understand. If you do stumble upon it, in the archives, or you stumble upon it, with recommendations, I hope it reaches to the right areas, right destinations, and I hope that, my channel, is seen and heard, so. To the community in Wonderland, here on Twitch, Punk is always there. So don't ever feel like you're alone. If you ever are in the mood to check out my channel, and chat with me, you're more than welcome to. I'm always jumping in, chatting with you guys in Wonderland more than I am chatting with my own community, because I don't have my own punk community. I don't have my own little niche. I don't have my own little family network of great supporters that the Wonderland community has graciously bestowed upon me. They have made me feel better days, and they made me feel like I mean something. I don't feel too depressed that I have people to talk to when I live stream. It's like I'm live streaming, I'm talking, but I'm literally just talking to the camera and to a non-existing chat at times, most times. So, it's embarrassing, but hey, it's the truth. But truth always sometimes is sadder than what we don't want to accept. And I accept that I'm not the greatest streamer. I accept that I'm not the most popular person on Twitch. I accept that I'm not the greatest guitar player. I accept, the feelings of being different. But nevertheless, I try to do the best I can. So, anyway, with all that said, I hope it was a great song. And it was fun to play. The melody was a really fun melody to enhance my skills on the guitar. I performed it with Rika Takanashi, my Sector guitar. So if anyone's interested in what type of guitar I was playing in the video, you can check out the video on YouTube. But on Twitch, you just heard it, you didn't see the video. But I was playing with my Rika Takanashi electric guitar. I wanted to do acoustic. I wanted to do acoustic, but I couldn't find the right melody with the acoustic. Even though acoustic would have been great, especially for the lyrics, but I couldn't find the melody. So I went with the electric, and I kind of just found something that worked. So, there you go. A little behind the scenes. But anyway, like I said, I hope everything goes well, smoothly. But for me, as we get back to what's at hand, I've been having technical difficulties of my own trying to manage the stream. With the updates and everything, I've been having to keep updating and reworking on Streamlabs, OBS, for the past 2 weeks. So I've been doing that. I've been working at the box company. And I've been live streaming here on Twitch for a while now, for almost a year now. I know we're in the month of June, but, you know, I've been doing good. People don't really ask me a lot of questions. Even though chat would have been like, oh, he's online. He's online, let's ask some questions. I wish. I wish it was that simple. I don't know how to grow a chat with the viewers. I don't. To be honest, most times people just lurk. People just watch it, but don't really, you know, pay too much attention to it. People don't really jump in and be like, hey, I followed your channel and I love your content. Keep up the great work. I've only had like one comment, and that was on my YouTube channel. Someone actually commented on one of my videos and said, you know, your music is actually really good. And I was appreciative of the comment. And, thank you. But someone did message me on Twitch. And they said, they asked me a question, but then they never asked me the question. They finally got back to me, and they finally asked me the question. And the question was, why am I single? And my answer to that question was, do you really want to know why I'm single? And in which they replied, yes, they really want to know. And to which I replied, well, there's like two reasons why I'm single. And the main reason why I'm single isn't a good reason why I'm single. And to be honest, I think I already mentioned it too many times to count, too many times to recall, that I think people got the gist. You know, I think people already understand, you know, who popular anime punk is, who punk is, and I think people are already, you know, at that point, they're just like, we just want you to do content. We want you to be good. We want you to feel happy and live stream. We want you to do great things with your time, you know. We want you to, you know, try to grow the community, try to reach out, try to, you know, give back, try to, you know, be popular as best as you can. And I'll try. And that's all I can do, is try. I can't stress it enough, but, you know, I've been, I've been really talking a lot, but I've also been listening a lot. And sometimes they don't even have to talk to me. Sometimes they don't even have to chat with me. I could just already pick up on what's going on, you know? Now, my sense of doubts and worries not as tense as they used to be. It's just the strange things of how many times I've been live streaming and how many times I've had to actually have no chat in the stream. How many times have I been on the air for longer than, you know, an hour, 4 hours, 5 hours, and I've only accumulated 2 viewers, and how many listeners were watching the channel. And I look into that, and I get it all back after I'm offline. So when I'm offline, I get a lot more viewership. And I think it's just because of the time zone difference. A lot of my viewers are coming from Australia, New Zealand, Europe. Not a lot from North America. I'm gonna look into something here. I go to my YouTube channel. I'm just gonna go to my YouTube channel, you know, because where we go. So on my YouTube channel, I have 68 subscribers. Which is pretty cool. Almost there. I'm almost there at 69. Very nice. Almost to 69. I'm at 68 subscribers. And I know it's not a lot to scoff at, but hey, it's pretty cool. For achievement, 3 weeks ago, I got like 30,000 views. So I look at the channel, you know, and I always love looking at the top geographics of audience and which audience I'm reaching out to. And a lot of the audience is coming from the United States. Some from India, some from Indonesia, some from the United Kingdom, and some from South Korea. Wow, like 2%. Show more. I'm curious now. I got some people from Germany, Brazil, Canada, Mexico, Spain, Vietnam. Huh. And our viewer age. Our viewer age of people that watch my videos on YouTube is like the highest is the 25 to the 34-year-old age. We have like 21% of like 18 to 24-year-olds that watch the channel. And in the 35 to 44-year range, we have like 23.8%. But most of the percentage is 25 to 34-year-olds, and that's like 40%. Huh. And I guess if you really want to see the gender of like male or female, I really don't care, honestly, male or female. that anyone can watch my channel, watch my videos. I don't really care. It doesn't really matter to me. It really doesn't affect me. You know, I really don't find it like offensive or anything. It's like, oh, well, okay, so I'm more aiming towards the male demographic, or I'm aiming towards the female demographic, or the LBQJ whatever community. You know, if I'm aiming towards, you know, reaching out wherever I am going out, you know, if someone likes my content, if someone likes my videos or my shorts, thank you. You know, if someone likes my channel and they want to follow my channel, thank you. It doesn't really matter where you are coming from. You know, it's great. You know, it's great because, you know, I know that I'm not alone. I know that I'm doing something right. You know, I know that my videos are getting out there. And I know that I'm not being, you know, isolated and segregated and put into categories. But for my category, it's variety streaming. Because, you know, like I said, sometimes I stream just talking. And sometimes I do the VR game play. But most of the time I really don't play. I don't do as much as what most creators and streamers do nowadays. I kind of do my own thing, but I still try to follow the guidelines. I follow the rules, you know, on every platform that I'm on. And I try to, you know, make the best of it. So. Mustache rules, right? So. But I've been on YouTube since February of 2013, and we're already in June of 2022. So I've been on YouTube for a long, like 2013, 2014, 2015, 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020. 2021, 2022. I've been on YouTube for 10 years. 10 fucking years. I've been on YouTube for 10 fucking years. Do I have a YouTube plaque yet? No, I don't. Because I only got like 68 viewers. 68 subscribers. You know? I haven't reached that benchmark or that goal of being, you know, popular. But I've been on the fucking platform for 10 fucking years. That's fucking amazing. Nevertheless, I mean, that's fucking amazing. You know, I know I'm on Twitch right now. You know, I'm talking about this, but I've been on Twitch for maybe 2014, 2015, 2016, 2017, 2018, 2020, 2021. 2022, for 8 years. So I've been on Twitch for 8 years. Because I started YouTube before I started Twitch. You know? And so I've been on platforms for a long time. And you would think for the amount of time I've been on, I would gain a lot of community backing and support. You would possibly think. But it's not that simple. No, it's not. For some odd reason, you know, we've had moments where I was down. I was recovering myself. I was having, you know, mental breakdowns, and I was dealing with, you know, personal issues that I needed to take care of, and I had to take a hiatus. So I'm coming back, but, you know, I'm still putting on live streams, I'm still recording videos, I'm still, you know, staying somewhat current on the platforms, you know, mentioning things, not like too personal of things, but just things that, you know, I could talk about. Now there's a lot of things I can't really talk about, but there's a lot of things I can talk about, but without a conversation, without conversations popping up in the chat, or on the Discord, or on the comment section, I can't really interact as much as the next person. If that makes sense. So, but nevertheless, Punk is here. Punk's doing good. And I had a doctor's appointment today, and my therapist was like, you know, you're improving, you know, we could see it, we could hear it. And my mom was like, well, maybe he's just trying to blow smoke up people's asses. No, I'm not. I'm not lying when I tell people that I'm actually feeling better about myself. I'm feeling a lot better about things. And making big improvement strides on bettering myself. You know, I actually took time to find myself, find out who I was, what I was. I'm a human being. I'm a human being. That's pretty much what it came down to. I'm a human being, and I have a heart. I have a brain. I have emotions. I'm alive. I'm alive, you know, and I'm living life. I'm living the dream. I'm living my dream. Now is my dream the greatest of dreams? Yeah. To some people be like, oh, you're just a normal guy. Pretty much. And to others, it's like, you know, I have, a unique style about me, but nothing too alarming, nothing too extreme, nothing too crazy. But nevertheless, I'm Punk. I go by Punk. Now people can call me by my first name, which is no problem. I have no issues with it. Just don't call me by my, like, all three names. Like, I always hate that. Growing up, when your parents would be like, call you by your first, your full name, it's like, shit, you're in trouble. I hate that feeling. To be honest, I really do hate that feeling. So, when I hear my whole full name said out loud, I'm just like, fucking Christ, what the fuck did I do now? You know, and I always try to catch myself and make sure that I don't get myself in trouble. Because I don't like having my full name being said for something bad. I'd rather have my full name said for something positive. That's just me. And I think that goes for everyone else. You know, everyone else out there, you know, they want their character and integrity, and their dignity to be intact. You know, they don't want their reputation, or not reputation, their... They don't want their ego to be tarnished. I don't have an ego. I really don't have an ego. Like, I know some people have, like, big egos. And they're just like, look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me. I'm Mr. Meesey, look at me. I'm Mr. Meesey, look at me. Now, I just completed the whole entire Rick and Morty series. For the first time. And, you know, I gotta tell you, I fucking love the show. I fucking love Rick and Morty's, the animation series. Fucking loved it. All the seasons. I finished them all. I binged them all. I know it's not anime, but it's animation. But I finished it, and now I'm just like, what the fuck do I watch now? And so, I think my favorite character is probably, Rick, you know? I enjoyed Rick, but I do enjoy Morty sometimes, but the Mr. Meese episode is like the most hilarious episode I've ever watched. I couldn't stop laughing. Though there are some great episodes, there are some episodes that are just like out there. But if no one's ever seen Rick and Morty, it is Adult Swim on Adult Swim series. It's actually a funny series to watch. You can watch it on Hulu if you have Hulu. But it's really cool. I hope they were gonna come up with another new season. I'm intrigued. Mr. Poopyhead. Oh my! Oh wow! Oh man! But right now the new series I'm starting off camera that I'm watching is I'm watching The Venture Bros. I'm watching Venture Bros, which is another Adult Swim TV series. It's on Hulu, so I'm trying to see what's on Hulu and finish what's watching on Hulu, because I finished pretty much all the Netflix series that I wanted to watch, and I'm just moved on to Hulu. So I'm trying to figure out what to watch on Hulu. And so I finished all that, and then it's like, oh, move on to Disney Plus, or, you know, but for me to talk about the new series, they have a new one on Disney Plus, Miss Marvel. I've been hearing commercials about it. Apparently it's supposed to be very empowering to women and young girls. It's cool. That's cool. I see the premise of what they're trying to pander, you know. I'm not saying it's a bad thing. I'm just saying I could see what they're trying to do with the commercials, you know, and the advertisements. And it's like, okay. Now, never read the comics, but I'll give it a whirl and watch a few episodes, but I'm not saying it's not recommended to watch. I mean, if you are hearing about it on your own, check it out. It's on Disney Plus. One of my family friends mentioned that Stranger Things has a new season on Netflix, so I'm a huge fan of Stranger Things, and I'm ready to see what the group has to overcome in the new season. So, like I said, that's what they talk about sometimes. Oh shit. We've been on for an hour. Oh. What's this? Oh, this is me singing Skater Boy karaoke. in my own punk version, my punk version of singing Skater Boy by Avril Lavigne. My own cover of it. I give it the punk style. What karaoke bar was this? Oh, this is during Halloween. Nope, this isn't Skater Boy. Sorry, this is Ramis. Guilty. Never mind. Wrong song. I apologize, I suck at singing. I'm going to my playlist. I'm gonna try to do something here. I'm just looking at things. What's this? Is this it? Rickrolled! Shit, we're being Rickrolled! Ah, here we go. Here's my version of Skater Boy by Avril Lavigne. Karaoke. In the crowd, looks at the man that she turned down. He was a skater boy, she said, see you later, boy. He wasn't good enough for her. Oh, karaoke. I've been going to a new karaoke bar called Mad Cats in Brewer. And it's really good. Great karaoke bar. I'm looking at my videos. Oh, Oh, damn. You know, the greatest, the most comments I ever got on all my videos, like when people comment on videos nowadays, they're great. But when I look at mine, a lot of the comments, that I've gotten, in the archives are from someone that is no longer here. But the messages that how I explain this? The heartfelt words of the moment that the person commented on the video. If I could go back and have a reply to that person, like, I would be totally appreciative. A lot of my comments that I read or liked were ones that were from my girlfriend at the time. And she was so supportive. My girlfriend was so supportive of me on live streaming and social media and being on YouTube. And you know, she never knew that I was going to do Twitch. But she knew that I was really dedicated on YouTube. And she was so supportive. And I lost a really supportive person in my life. And it's struggling at times to know that when you have a really supporting person in your life that would, you know, that's always just reaching out and commenting and supporting you day in, day out. It means a lot. And, I look back, I kind of look back at my past videos to make improvements, or just to reflect on things, at times, off camera. And, it makes me happy to know that I'm doing something right. I'm doing the best I can for what I set myself up to do. I didn't set myself up for failure. I could tell you that. And if I did fail, you know, I tried my hardest to make up for it. Speaking of failure, I wrote a song called Failure Isn't Bad, and I'm gonna share it here on Twitch, so have a listen. It's called
Make the Best of It.
Failure Isn't Always Bad. So check out and listen to Failure Isn't Always Bad here on Pop Your Anime Punks live stream. I'll be right back. Gotta take care of the dog.
In a failure, in a failure. Did I impress you as a failure? Did I break your heart as a failure? Have I earned your respect as a failure? Have I turned away? Have I gone insane? Have I turned you away? Have we gone our separate ways? Are we failures or are we still distant? Are we failures or are we distant? don't know if we're cruising different paths. Still think you're on my side when I look into my eyes. Maybe it's just a mirage of the heat exhaustion. Are we failing? Are we still sailing? Are we failing? Are we still sailing? Do you still need me? Or are you through with me? Do you still need me? Or are you through with me? Am I failing you? Or am I failing you? Are we failing each other? Or am I failing myself? Are we failing each other? Are we failing ourselves? Are we still in love? Probably not. Probably not. Have I failed you? Have you failed me? Have I failed you? Or did you fail me? Have I impressed you? Have I not? To be or not to be? Is there love for you and me? To be or not to be? Is there love for you and me? Are we failing in love, my friend? Are we failing love once again? Yes, it's true, I feel something, and yes, it's true, I feel the change. Are we failing in love? Yes, it is. No, it's not. Are we failing each other's expectations of what we want out of each other? Are we failing what we want out of each other? Are we failing love, yes or no? I don't really know if it's meant to be. To be or not to be, are we still feeling love, my friend? Are we still feeling love, my friend? Did we lose expectations of each other? Yes or no? Sometimes we got to know. Yes or no? Sometimes we got to know. Yes or no? Sometimes we got to know. Yes or no? Sometimes we got to know.
So that was called Failing Isn't Always Bad. Like I said, It's my music. It's my artistic creation of playing poetry with song and music. Epic. I wrote another song that I would like to stream, and for you, the viewers and listeners out there, and the watchers, to hear. It's called Save My Breath. I originally wrote it, having a moment in time in which I was reflecting on how, you know, I've been really having a positive outlet, lately, and having a positive, aspect of, moving forwards with my life. As difficult and as challenging as my life is, there's others out there. You can agree on this. There's others out there that are having more difficult times and challenging times. But to stay strong and to manage to wade through the rough times and even the good times, that makes us strong in the heart and the mind. So don't ever give up on yourself. And I stress this enough. I can't stress this enough. Don't ever, ever feel like it, giving up on yourself or giving up on others. Don't ever feel that. Because you're not alone. You know, there are people out there that care. And I care. You know, I care. So, and if I care, then maybe the next person cares. And if the next person cares, then they care. And the next person cares, and so on, 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 and so on. You know? Don't give up. That's the message of Save My Breath. So, don't give up. A lot of my songs lately now have been about not giving up. Not giving in to, you know, the sadness. Not giving in to the moments of feeling like you're absolutely drowning and you have no connection whatsoever to reaching out and getting help. So a lot of my songs right now have been moving in a artistic way of trying to tell others that I'm not feeling too low about myself, and I want others to know that, really truthfully. I really want others to know that, and I want them to hear that in the sound of my voice and listening to my music and my videos, you know. So I wrote this song called Save My Breath. And I want everyone to have a listen to it. Now you can check this out on your own on YouTube, called Save My Breath.
Drowning.
So like I said, it's called Save My Breath. And it's a good song. I enjoy playing it. Did it get 1.1k views? No. No, it did not. It only got like 4 views on YouTube. Like I said, I don't get a lot of views. I don't get a lot of viewers. I don't get a lot of views on a lot of my videos. I want views. I would like appreciate views. I appreciate viewers, and support. But I don't get it a lot. But the video, the song that I wrote, "Save My Breath." It's about a daydream in which I felt like I was drowning in the ocean, and my angel, my guardian angel, if you believe in guardian angels, rescued me from feeling depressed again, and brought me back to life. So that's the whole concept of the song, behind the music, if that it makes sense. So I was really appreciative of coming up with that on my own. I do enjoy the melody. It is it's grungy. It has punk vibes, punk type melody, but it's raw. It's truthful, and it's my way of expression in music. So it's epic to me. It's epic to me. I don't know if it's epic to everyone else listening to it, but if you liked it, you can check it out for your own free time on YouTube, and give it a like, give it a comment, give it a dislike if you don't like it. But I have another song that I would like to share on on Twitch. It's called 5 Minutes. And the 5 minute song is it's literally 5 minute song. It's literally a 5 minute song. funny. But it's in 5 minutes, a lot of things can happen. Sometimes when you're sad, a lot of things can happen in 5 minutes. And so I wrote a song to reflect on that. And that was during a time that I was feeling a little bit low about myself. But now that I'm not, you know, and I'm in the right mindset, I wanted to play the song. So for anyone listening here on Twitch, they can hear it and make their own judgment on it, and like it or not like it, or just listen to it, you know, just spend time listening to my creativity of guitar playing. All my songs, all my lyrics are of my own. So Pop Your Anime Punk, copyright there. I try not to copy other people's creativity. So I try, you know, do my own songs and music to share. So anyway, it's called 5 minutes. So I'm just gonna listen to it. There's no video, when I filmed it and recorded it, I had the camera facing the fan, so it's just nothing but a fan, so I don't want to share the video. I'll just let you listen to it.
Another thing.
try and teach them something new today. Got some and you're trying to teach them something new today.
Never knew, but you
So 5 minutes. So like I said, it's a heavy song. It's a really, really heavy song. Emotionally heavy song. For if you're listening to it. I mean, if you're actually, like, seriously, like, sitting down and actually listening to it, it really should resonate with a lot of people. It should really resonate with a lot of people. And a lot of people's ears should be like, because it, you know, it is a personal song. It took me 5 years. Literally, it took me 5 years to write this song. To come up with a really decent melody and to share it here on Twitch and on YouTube, and to share my guitar skills and how I have improved my guitar skills over the 5 years. That's what the song seems like its purpose was, from the lyrics. If you're listening to the lyrics really closely, but if you really want to know, like, the true backstory of it is, basically I was depressed, and I didn't want to hurt myself, I didn't want to hurt others, so I wrote a song to, share my way of coping, through guitar, and hoping that the song would, not be a cry for help, but be like a sign of, you know, taking sadness and mixing it and putting out something that's positive that can be uplifting. And that's really what I am trying to do. I'm trying to battle my inner demons of depression. And I'm trying to flip the tables around and put a smile on my face. It's not easy. From the lyrics, like I said, I learn something new every day. But certain things are challenging, and it takes me 5 times to figure out. So, how many times does it take me to figure it out? You know, how many times did it take someone else to figure it out? Did it take them 5 times? Or did it take them like that instantly to figure it out? What you don't know of the day, you learn something new every day. But yet you can't forget what you learned the day before. So it's one of those life learning skills. So I did notice that we did have some viewers that were popping in, probably lurkers, but we did reach 3 viewers, so that was pretty cool. So thank you for lurking, thank you for being a stranger, and watching the channel. Thank you very much. Now that we reached the 2-hour mark here on the channel, I really can't stress it enough that my music should be a lot more. There should be a lot more viewers, viewership. I get more viewership on my shorts, to be honest. I do like little short videos, and people like that. I get more viewership on that. But when I actually do like my own music, as raw and as, you know, somewhat edited to a degree, doesn't really get enough recognition. So, I hope the platforms get a lot of recognition in the future. Maybe tomorrow. Maybe in 5 days. Who knows? All I do know is that I can't give up. Like all my songs, you know, I try my hardest. Try my hardest not to give up. That's a song.
Been sitting for a while.
Wow. So, that song I wrote back in 2020, and that was called If Angels Were So Kind, Can They Send Me Some Bandages? I write a lot of not depressing material. I mean, people, like, contemplate, they're like, oh, you listen to My Chemical Romance, you're just emo, you're suicidal, you have issues. No. It doesn't make you a bad person. It doesn't make you a mean person. It doesn't make you an evil person. It makes you a person that is going through struggles, going through a lot of hardships, and a lot of battles that a lot of people don't give two fucks about. They don't care. You know, they don't really care for the whole shock factor. Because they once the shock factor's over, everything's settled. Everything's kinda like, okay, now what? So then, you know, when people find help, when people find, you know, recovery, and they find outlets to help themselves and to better themselves, they abandon them. They just fucking abandon them. They don't reach out and say, hey, how you doing? They don't keep tabs. They just fucking split up. And that's what I feel like a lot of the community has done to me. You know? And I feel like maybe that's what my followers have done to me. Maybe. It's like I've gotten the help that I needed, and now it's like, all right, fuck off, and they piss off, and it's like, okay. But that's just maybe just my thought on it. But nevertheless, my music, it's not supposed to influence anyone to hurt themselves or hurt others. I don't want that to happen. I don't want to be affiliated for that. I don't want to be known for that. So, but like I said, I play a lot of different type of music, different types of genre. But most of it is in the punk rock, emo community, emotional community factors. And I really enjoy that song. To be honest, it was a really great song to get off my chest. It was a really great song to write down. And it was a really great song to play on the guitar. And I really enjoy the melody of it. And to share it, like, I'm not embarrassed. I'm not ashamed of sharing this song. Because it's like listening to The Used, you know? A lot of people like the band, you know, and a lot of the songs are about, you know, self-infliction. And I don't really pick up on that, but I mean, but when I've heard it, you know, by really, really listening to it and listening to the lyrics, I was like, oh, like, he's going through some struggles. I hope he gets help. I hope he finds recovery, you know? So, I hope people find recovery. I hope people find better outlets, better chance of life, you know? Even though my life, it really means absolutely nothing compared to everyone else's, because, like I said, I'm not living everyone else's life. Everyone else has better lives than me. Even though they may think differently, they may think, no, my life is in a struggle and a shambles too, and I'm struggling as well, but it's like, no, you're not. You're doing better than me. You're doing better than me. So if you're doing better than me, great. I'm doing better for myself. And so each day, you know, I can count down the days and be like, well, today was a good day. So I share a lot of my music, and I go into my archives and I share music. I wrote a song called Karen Has Some Issues. Alright, so I'm going to play one last song, because I don't want people to get the wrong impression of the stream. I don't want people to take everything out of context. I want people to appreciate my music, and appreciate the channel, and still support it. And I have one more song I'm going to share, and it's called Don't Go to Bed with Grudge. Don't Go to Bed with a Grudge on Your Head. We haven't listened to it. So have a listen to this song called Don't Go to Bed with a Grudge on Your Head. I'll be right back. Cooper needs to go out.
Cooper, come on, buddy. Oh,
fix the physical feelings of death. You don't want to go to sleep with crutches on your head. Don't fall, you don't make you sick and tired. Don't make you drink all the empty bottles. Don't make you take the pills. Don't make you cut your wrist. Don't go to sleep with crutches on your head. In the daytime, you will be miserable, sitting in a room, haunted by your memories of loss and despair. The crutch will haunt you till the very end. A soul that's never been put to rest. There's no time. Play for the absent. Like a dove.
bet it was a grudge on your head. So, make up with all your enemies, make up with everything. Have a great night. Have a great day. Hang in there, everyone. I'm Punk. And, thank you for listening, thank you for watching, thank you for viewing the channel, for supporting the channel. Till then, I'm gonna leave it here. I'll be back on the air tomorrow for another hour and a half live streaming on Twitch. So, got another day ahead of us. So, hope everyone has a great rest of their Wednesday evening. I will bid a farewell and adieu. And there's a moth in my room. Okay. So good night, everyone. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Maybe next time we get a chat. But nevertheless, thank you for spending time.